Let's return to our original goal, which was to sketch the response without even bothering to solve for it. The steps were to find how many exponentials and how many time constants, and we note immediately that s equals negative 2, or tau is equal to 1/2, and there's only one exponential. Finding the final value is just a matter of crossing out the derivatives, which lets us know that x is heading towards a final value of 1/2. The initial condition we already knew. We are starting at time 0, and we want to point the initial slope of our system response at a value of 0.5. So if we sketch this out, we're sketching x of t with a final value of 0.5. and also a time constant of 0.5. I'll sketch out the asymptote as a dashed line. We know that we need to be about 63% of the way, so the value here should be 0.63 times 0.5, or about 0.315. Let me also sketch in the initial slope, which should be such that we're aiming from time 0 with a straight line at the final value. And then the only thing that's left to do is to try to sketch in the shape, roughly, so that we start off aligned with our straight line and then gradually deviating from it with a rough exponential shape. And then it might be helpful to label this as 63% or 0.315. And then if we were so interested, we would also note 1% at around a value of 4.6 times 0.5, which would be about 2.3. So some of the things I should note in when we're looking at these sketches, we want to label everything. We want to label the axes. So here we have t and x of t. We want the final value and the initial value, both shown very clearly. We want the initial slope and the time constant shown. And we want some indicator of where we are somewhere along the curve, as you see here with this annotation.